So let's say he pulled some sort of guard, or I took him down, and I'm here from the beat. Right, so I'm going to show you a real nice basic but high percentage Achilles lock entry, okay? So what I want to do is I want to start to control either his knees or his feet, alright? I just don't want him, you know, posting me away too far and, like, you know, really shitting off or yet even sitting up on me or something like that. So I'm kind of just here on his knees. I'm going to step between his legs with one of my legs, okay? So in this case, I'm going to step on my right leg, okay? My left hand, so the opposite hand, is going to pick up that ankle, okay, closest to me. Now watch what I'm going to do. When I'm ready to execute the ankle lock, I'm going to grab just above his knee, all right? And that's going to help sort of cushion my fall when I fall back. There's no need to jump backwards, right? If you guys ever watched, like, the early UFCs, like Ken Shamrock would go for leg locks. And damn near knock himself out by throwing himself back. He couldn't get backwards fast enough. Completely unnecessary, okay? So I'm here. I step between, I pick up his ankle, and I attack above his knee. Now watch what I do. I'm gonna pull this up to my armpit, and I'm gonna look to use an angle of my forearm right here and use Achilles tendon. Okay? Here. Once I'm there, this outside leg steps, I squat and I sit. And as I sit, I'm sliding up to his Achilles. All right, so Brandon sits back, he'll see that I'm here, I slide up to his Achilles. The leg that was in the center is gonna curl underneath where his hamstring and glute meet. The outside ankle is gonna attack on the hip, and now I'm gonna push my knees. From here, I look to grab the back part of my hand on a guillotine grip. So I'm here. All right, now I don't go straight back. Can I generate pressure? Yes. Can I generate enough pressure on a tough guy to finish? Not really. So what do? I roll over my shoulder and that captures his leg. It's pinched between the mat, my arm, and my ribs, his leg. So if he tries to kick really hard, it's difficult for him to escape from there. Not only that, it helps me pinch because I'm on my side. Now watch what I do. I use this foot to push off the hip. I roll my grip north. And I start to engage my hips, and I start to get my ankle lock finished. So if his leg was here, okay, well, let's say I was right here, I went backwards, I'll go back as far as I can. That's about as far as I can go. But if I bring him to the side, and let's say his leg is here, I have way more range of motion. He'll run out of space before I run out of space, all right? So one more time. Control the knees, step, attack, pick up here, just above the, just above his heel to his Achilles tendon, attack, step, sit, and I'm pulling myself into the position with the top arm. This pinches, captures, I go over the leg, and I almost want to look to the mat, okay? I don't want to be looking at him, because this is closing the door more. Okay, now look, hips, drive. His leg was still in here. It's game over for him. All right, let's do it. Achilles lock. 3, 2, 1.